I can't let her get away with it.
No, I know you can't. You can't. I broke some of that pip of the.
Okay.
The mission of the vaults should be important to everyone.
Guys, huge congrats on Fallout. I aspire to your levels of badass in this.
Really?
Same, honestly.
Yeah, it's mutual.
It's not real.
You come from a world of rules, of laws. You should not be alone.
But Ella, how did it feel using the Pip-Boy for the first time?
It was really, really cool. It's an iPhone sideways in this sort of magnetic contraption that also clicks on. It's funny because I think originally they tried to make it like true to scale from the game and it was so big, so they had to sort of scale down a little bit to make it, you know, fit and everything. But it was, Aaron's giving me a look because I
can't let her get away with it.
No, I know you can't. You can't. I broke some of that pip of the pip.
Okay. Boys. How? How did you?
I'm clumsy and I break things. And I fall over and
I'm too excited.
And it, you know, if I like to talk with my hands and I would talk and it would just fly across the room. So I think I probably broke a few iPhones.
That was an exciting day. I always knew on set if I heard cut, Lucy broke the Pip-Boy again.
You're like, oh, standard. Like,
she's into it.
Oh, sorry.
Sorry to the Pip-Boy.
Sorry to Pip-Boy gods.
Aaron, for you, were you actually in a suit and how did it feel stepping foot inside if you were in one?
Okay, yes, well, we have different sort of suits. There's versions of it. There's the clamshell is what we call it, which is sort of statuesque, but the back is open and can, you know, I step into it and it can close around me. It's like activating the suit. That one's really fun. There's our main stunt actor, Adam Shippey, who's in the hero suit. So he's massively tall already, but then, you know, on these platforms in the big 100-plus-pound suit, he's 7 foot something, you know what I mean? He's just a gigantic robot man walking around. And then I wear the top half of the suit. So I look like a gigantic robot man, but only half of me, and I've got these little tiny normal human legs underneath it.
A couple Apple boxes.
Just one Apple box. I just need one. I need one for Eyeline, for Ella. I need a couple sometimes. No, it's really fun. There's still the aspect of shooting inside the helmet as well, but it's so many different elements to bring the suit to life.
I know I wouldn't last a millisecond in the wasteland. Ella, how well do you think that Jackie from Yellowjackets would cope in this world?
She'd die instantly. Instantly. No, I mean, I think it depends if she was able to meet people, and maybe form a group, then she might have a better chance. But by herself, I don't think she would fare too well.
I don't think so as
no.
well. Who out of your Yellowjackets co-stars, though, would you want to take with you on your mission in this?
Like in real life or the characters?
In real life.
Oh, God. You know, Stephen is quite resourceful. He's gone camping and stuff. Like, he could make a fire. Sophie is hilarious and would just keep me up laughing.
So she'd bring the lols.
Yeah, it'd probably be Anne Courtney. I mean, all of them. Liv is also really resourceful. I don't know. I can't choose. It's too hard.
You're like, bring them all.
Just bring everyone. Get the gang back together.
Bring them all to the wasteland. Yeah. But obviously the series is set after the apocalypse. If all was to end now, what's one movie that you'd be taking with you to the vaults?
Ooh, that's rough.
A good film.
You know, I think I would want something like light-hearted and nostalgic and heartwarming. You know, like an animated Toy Story, the first one.
Classic.
It's a classic. Yeah.
You'll never get bored.
And it's nice, it's wholesome. What about you?
Pulp Fiction.
Really?
I don't know, I gotta choose something that's like three movies in one, really. You know what I mean? There's a lot in it.
Yeah.
I don't think I get tired of it.
It's quite an intense one, though.
It's
a good one.
If I don't need the intensity, if my life is too intense, I'll just skip.
You might get bored in the vault, so it might be good to have some intensity.
Ooh, but vaults would be boring.
Yeah. Just want to start.
I've had a rough week. Practically every person I've met up here was tried to kill.
People are going to be falling in love with Lucy and Maximus. What qualities do you guys share with them?
Well, I think that there's a lot of... I relate a lot to Maximus, but I do think he's very different than me. You know, I relate to an internal struggle, that sort of war going on within oneself. I think we all can relate to that. You know, Maximus has just lived his whole life in the wasteland. He's born and raised, so that's why I see so much difference, too, is my moral compass is a little more aligned with, I think, ours today.
I would say.
You think so?
I'd say so.
She spent enough time with me to know.
I'd say you have a good moral compass.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
And how about for you, Ella?
You know, I think I share a certain optimism, maybe, with Lucy. I'm not quite as naive, I like to think. But she's good in a crisis, and she can find a positive in a really bad situation. I don't always use it, but I do have the ability somewhere in me to do that. You know, if it all goes wrong, I'm the one that's like, come on, guys, we can do this.
Everyone wants to save the world, they just... to disagree on how. There you are, you little killer.
You guys must have spent so much time together filming. What's the most interesting thing you learnt about each other while shooting this? Aside from the fact that Ella always breaks the Pip-Boys.
Besides the Pip-Boy monstrosity that she is. No, she's an incredible... Ella's an incredible advocate for so many people working on a set. And if you know, it's something massive like this. It's 200 of us working on set, and really all of us are sacrificing. To accept work in this industry is to sacrifice, you know. And we're all working really hard to make the thing work, and there's another 200 off camera and in post, you know. So... She's always a good advocate. I've seen this person stand up for people just for their own comfort, so that they have a better working environment, and we all feel a little closer. She's a good leader.
That was a really nice thing you just said.
She's about to say something terrible about
me. I feel emotional after hearing that.
Well,
God, the pressure. God. Aaron doesn't read the scripts. He's actually improvised.
Script
the
reads
whole
me.
Thing.
Somehow I find myself online.
I am the script.
Somehow the thoughts come out correctly.
I know, Aaron's a great actor. You know, I actually had no idea how any of the Brotherhood of Steel stuff was going to look. Because I wasn't in Utah where you shot that.
We didn't
any
allow
of that
you.
Stuff.
We didn't allow you.
No, they wouldn't let me into Utah. So that first scene that we see, it's not actually one of the first scenes, but first episode, there is a certain scene that Aaron just brings it, and it's emotional and so good. And I cried the first time I watched it.
Really?
Yeah, I was actually sat next to you, and I had to turn away so you couldn't see me.
Really?
I got a little teary. It was really emotional.
Yeah, who's looking out for Maximus?
Who's looking out for Max?
Mm-hmm. You're the dream duo. The game is obviously so loved. Who out of your friends and family had the best reaction when you told them that you were cast?
You know,
I did have a stammering cousin, you know, where it's that thing where he's like, I've known you your whole life, but now you don't know how to talk to me, you know? That was when I was like, it's a real fan. It's a real fan of the game
really
there.
That's really sweet. Yeah. I didn't really have that. I had some friends really freaked out, or I don't know. I also tend to sort of downplay things as well. So I'm like, I don't know, I'm doing this Fallout thing, you guys heard of it?
No,
but one of my friends was like, the video game, you know, like it's amazing when you see people who are so passionate about the games, like, you know, like it really, yeah. It means so much to them, and that's really exciting. But I don't know, it kind of freaks me out because I'm like, oh God, hope you like it.
Your cousin is going to be another level when this comes out, by the way.
I think so.
I'm worried for him. Guys, huge congrats. The series is absolutely brilliant, and I can't wait for people to see it.
Thank you
so much. Appreciate that.